Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
Cutter Family Auto Centers and Wendt Okolie present Ohana Road and the Armed Forces TV at the Los Angeles Auto Show. Featuring all the latest and greatest cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs coming your way, with a visit to a fabulous aftermarket display, a look at 2007s and cars of tomorrow, exotic cars from around the world, and a special salute to the troops right here on Ohana Road with your host, Dale Payson, direct from the Los Angeles Convention Center.
Aloha, everyone, and welcome to a special edition of Ohana Road. I'm Dale Payson here on the floor of the Los Angeles Convention Center for the first international auto show of the season, the 2007 Greater Los Angeles Auto Show. They've got over 1,000 cars here, over 20 new cars debuting for the first time ever, concept vehicles, what we like to say, the latest cars, trucks, and SUVs coming your way. So kick back in the Lazy Boy, leave the driving to us. Tonight's episode of Ohana Road starts right after this.
Ford F-150, big, powerful, durable, and you can get one for only $226 a month at Cutter Ford. That's solid value, and that's why Cutter says, dare to compare. If you test drive an F-150 but buy any other truck in its class, we'll give you your choice of a $50 Costco gift certificate or membership. See Cutter Ford for full details.
Would you install these parts in your car? Get real. Get real name brand auto parts at your Hawaii Auto Value Parts Store, where ASE certified counter pros will get you the parts you need at the value you expect. We carry name brand original equipment parts for all import and domestic cars and trucks. Visit the Auto Value location nearest you today.
When you get real name brand auto parts, you get real auto value.
Hey, you ready yet?
Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered. Dude, I'm sorry.
Weta Cole seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name. Weta Cole.
California has long been considered the lifestyle of America, the trendsetter, and that's why there are over 14 studios that design cars here in the Southland. Also fitting why so many cars should be debuted here at the 2007 Greater Los Angeles Auto Show. But to kick off the show, we have a state of the industry address by CEO of General Motors, Rick Wagner.
We at GM believe tomorrow's automobiles must be flexible enough to accommodate many different energy sources. A key part of that flexibility will be enabled by the development of electrically driven cars and trucks. We're committed to leading in both technology and design, and we can't wait to show you what we have coming down the road. We at GM see a logical journey from standalone, largely mechanical automobiles to vehicles that run on electricity. At the end of the day, this transformation will be as important as the transition from horses to horsepower. We believe that no company is better positioned to make it happen than General Motors. It's an unrivaled opportunity to really reinvent the automobile, as well as the auto business itself. I have no doubt that when the LA Auto Show celebrates its 125th anniversary, it'll look back at this time as a period of great change and as the formative years of the age of the electrically driven automobile. Thanks very much.
Time for us to check out General Motors' latest offerings. Let's see what's happening at Buick, Chevrolet, Pontiac, and GMC trucks. And what's with the flying Corvette? I'm here with Mike Jackson from General Motors. Well, I want to ask you what's happening for General Motors, and we'll start with Buick. What's going on in Buick division?
Well, there's a lot happening. Last night, we unveiled the production version of the Buick Enclave, which is an 8-passenger crossover SUV, car-like handling, absolutely beautiful. Rick Wagner and Tiger Woods actually presented that to the press, and interestingly enough, it is very close to the concept vehicle that was shown here a few years ago. Buick Lucerne's awesome. It's doing a really, really nice job in the marketplace. Quiet, very refined, kind of luxury ride, significant value, you know, with one of the best warranties in the business. A lot going on at Chevrolet. As you know, we just launched Silverado, our country, our truck, pretty bold campaign. We're really excited with what's happening there. We just learned that Four Wheeler Magazine gave the best pickup to the Chevy Avalanche, the new Chevy Avalanche, which is a great, great truck. Of course, we launched the Tahoe and Suburban, and they're doing extremely well. Small Chevys, we got the new Avail. It's doing extremely well. We got the Cobalt and multiple versions of that. The Cobalt SS Coupe doing really, really well. So on the small end, again, Chevy doing really well.
And we can't talk about Chevrolet without talking about America's sports car.
Corvette. You know, what can I say? I mean, the Z06 and the C6, you know, one of the hottest vehicles in the market. We continue to sell every one we produce. You know, it's got such a loyal following, and if you've driven the new Corvette, it is the quietest, nicest ride, handling and performance ever built in a sports car. And of course, the G6 line is now in the market, you know, all three versions, coupe, sedan, as well as the hardtop convertible, doing extremely well. And then Pontiac Solstice, and again, we just launched the Performance GXP version of the Pontiac Solstice. GMC is doing extremely well. GMC, in essence, is going to have an all-new lineup for 2007-2008. As you know, we launched Yukon and Yukon XL. 50% of Yukon sales are now Denali, the upscale version, and that's up from like 25% a few years ago. In a couple of weeks, actually, we began launching the Acadia, which is, again, 8-passenger crossover. Very, very well done. And it'll be a new addition for the GM showroom. So when you look at what's happening with GMC, you're going to find that the full-size utilities, professional grade, the full-size pickups, Sierra, just absolutely great truck. You add the Acadia to the mix. And again, literally, most of what's going to be sold in the GMC showroom is going to be new or all new products. So we're excited about GMC. And then, of course, Saturn's got the View Green Line. The new View Green Line just showed the Aura hybrid version as well. So just a lot of very good stuff going on, very, very tactical way. And as we're very focused on ensuring that we continue our leadership in developing the most fuel-efficient, lowering our dependency on foreign oil vehicles of any automaker in the world. So a lot going on there.
Mike, thanks so much, and keep up the good work at General Motors.
Thank you.
Of course, it wouldn't be an auto show without a look into the automotive future with the concept cars. Here are a few of our favorites.
You've seen it in the magazines. Here it is in real life, and it is gorgeous. The Dodge Challenger Concept, sitting on 20-inch wheels with a 6.1-liter Hemi engine, unbelievable power, and the butterfly hood scoops. You gotta love it in this beautiful orange color. Will it be built in 2008 or 2009? Keep it tuned to Ohana Road. We'll keep you posted.
Ford wowed the motoring press with the latest rendition of its famous pony car, the new Mustang Concept, complete with gullwing doors. The Volkswagen Tiguan Concept. This vehicle is said to be 98% close to what Volkswagen will offer in mid-2008 in your choice of gasoline or diesel.
You know, one of the coolest luxury cars I ever remember as a kid, my best friend's dad had one, was a Chrysler Imperial. They went out of production many years ago, actually came back in the 80s for a short time. This is the new Chrysler Imperial Concept. The question, will they build it or will they not?
And one of the coolest concepts we've seen in a long time, the very futuristic Mazda Nagare concept.
Aloha. Hey, on behalf of all my colleagues with GM around the world, really want to take this opportunity to salute you who so diligently protect the freedom that we enjoy in America. So again, on behalf of all of us at GM, thank you, thank you, thank you for what you do. We really appreciate it. Keep up the good work. When you return home, we got a nice GM vehicle waiting for you. Thank you.
The Chevy Impala. Stylish. Economical. Built to last.
And you can get one for only $23,788 at Cutter Chevrolet. And that's why Cutter says, dare to compare. If you test drive an Impala but buy any other car in its class, we'll give you your choice of a $50 Costco gift certificate or membership. See Cutter Chevrolet for full details.
Hey, you ready yet?
Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered.
Cool. I'm sorry.
Weta Cole seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name. Weta Cole.
Celebrate Brew Moon's fifth anniversary with our Brewer's Blast. From now till the end of summer, happy hour on the moon all day and all night with $3 beers. Lunch, dinner, and late night dining with high quality microbrews, great poo-poos, and live music Tuesday through Saturday. Brew Moon. Come for the beer, stay for the fun. Second level Ward Center. See you at the moon.
My favorite part of the auto show got to be the exotics, and it doesn't get much more exotic than this beautiful Bugatti Veyron. This is just an unbelievable car, 1,001 horsepower, 0 to 62 miles per hour, 2.5 seconds. Look at this interior. It is the most sumptuous car I have ever seen. Absolutely gorgeous. Would you like to have one? $1.2 million, and you could take it home.
Here's an exotic brand from the Netherlands called Spyker. These Dutch supercars are all hand-built with high-performance engines. And for about $268,000, you and your friends could cruise Kalakaua in this C12 Laturbi with its 500-horsepower W12 engine and a top speed of 196 miles per hour. If red is your favorite color, you might like driving one of these beautiful Ferraris. The pride of Italy and champs of Formula One, Ferraris are always a head-turner and a must-see at the show. Originally the pride of England and now owned by Volkswagen, the Bentleys looked very stately. At $190,000 a copy, you can see why a Chrysler 300C is such a bargain.
Of course, you've heard Ford has a better idea. Let's check in with the Blue Oval boys to see what's new for 2007.
The new Ford Escape is America's best-selling compact sport utility. This five-passenger SUV offers both cargo space and optional all-wheel drive, powered by your choice of either a four-cylinder or six-cylinder engine. Striking, bold design, and stimulating driving dynamics merge in the all-new Ford Fusion. Ford's flagship midsize car, the Fusion promises agility and power with a light, nimble ride and lots of legroom. The Ford 500 reinvents the family sedan with passenger comfort and best-in-class legroom for front and rear passengers. The Ford 500 combines technology under the hood to create a dynamic driving experience. A new 3-liter Duratec V6 engine and 6-speed automatic transmission optimizes both performance and fuel economy. Inspired by the Boss Mustang of the 1970s, the new Mustang GT is nonetheless a thoroughly modern car. The GT delivers the bold styling, rear-wheel drive performance, and affordability that have been Mustang hallmarks for decades. With its 300-horsepower V8 engine, the new Mustang GT lives up to its legend. And we've said it before, the world's biggest-selling car is really a truck. The famous Ford F-150 pickup sets new standards for toughness, interior spaciousness, and cargo capacity. The F-150 offers the industry's widest variety of body configurations.
We're here in Los Angeles, of course, always looking for celebrities. You'll never guess who we found. Kermit the Frog. Kermit, what are you doing at the LA Auto Show?
No, I'm actually here because my friends at Ford want me to talk to people about their new Ford Escape Hybrid for 2008. No, it's cool. It runs on gas and electric. You know, it's like a full hybrid, runs on electric up to about 30 miles an hour, and then switches over to gas. Gets great fuel economy. It's the most fuel-efficient SUV in the world. And green issues are pretty important to a frog like me.
Well, Kermit, thank you so much for sharing a little bit of your time with us.
Oh, listen, no problem. It's nice to see you.
Aloha, everyone. Hi, I'm Barry Redler from Ford Motor Company, and I'm one of the group brand managers at Ford, and we'd like to salute you today for everything that you do on our behalf. Thanks for all the efforts. Congratulations on the effort. We wish you safety, and we wish you all to come home soon. Thanks on behalf of Ford.
And now with the latest news from Mazda, here's Mazda brand president Jim O'Sullivan.
Hey, it's great to be back here at the Los Angeles International Auto Show. Well, the last time that we were here at the Los Angeles International Auto Show, when you think about it, was only about 10 months ago. Mazda was in the process of introducing a whole new slew of vehicles, and we have. First of all, this summer, we introduced the all-brand new five-passenger crossover CX-7 vehicle, followed by what we feel is the fastest front-wheel drive production car in the world, the Mazda Speed 3, with a top speed recently rated in the Autobahn at 155 miles an hour. We then followed with the MX-5 Miata retractable hardtop, which is the fastest retractable hardtop within the entire industry, along with the benefit that you don't lose any trunk space at all. We then certainly followed, obviously, with the pre-launch getting ready for the all-new CX-9 seven-passenger crossover, which will go on sale later on this year, along with the new Tribute, which we'll be launching in the first quarter. So it's been a real busy 10 months for Mazda, and it's going to be a busy several months as we go forward. But the showroom for Mazda right now is the best that it's ever been in its history, with a complete lineup with Mazda 3, Mazda 6, CX-7, CX-9, MX-5 retractable hardtop Miata, and a great line of cars and trucks. I want to do a great salute to all the troops out there, all the armed forces all over the world. You guys and gals are doing a fantastic job. We love you. We pray for you every day. Salute you guys. Love you. Praying for you every day. And kick some butt, because we support you 100%.
We caught up with Volkswagen's PR guru, Keith Price. Keith, what's new for 2007 from Volkswagen?
We got some exciting things going on here at the day one of Press Days of the LA Auto Show. The EOS is our Swiss Army knife of cars. It's a convertible, it's a sunroof, and it's a secure hardtop. It's really for the person who wants it all. The new Jetta is doing really well in the marketplace, and, you know, talk about a car that size that you can fit that much stuff in the trunk. I've got a Jetta myself. You wouldn't believe how big the trunk is. The Rabbit is back. It was with us from 1975 through 1984, and as of June of 2006, it's back with us. It starts at a base price of $14,990, very well equipped. We got the Touareg SUV. It's available with a V10 TDI diesel that makes 553 foot-pounds of torque. It'll make you giggle. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Keith. Here at the LA Auto Show, there are all kinds of cars, including race cars. Check out this beautiful 200-mile-per-hour American Le Mans Series racer. Imagine taking that up H3, huh? Just kidding, HPD. Speaking of racing, here's Anita with some racing news.
Dale, while you're having fun at the Los Angeles Auto Show, I'm holding the fort down in Honolulu. And I just got some breaking news that you won't believe. The folks at Yahoo may be taking environmental cars a bit too far. They had a truck built to run on grease. That's right, cooking oil. They tested it at the El Mirage Dry Lakes Auto Racing Arena in California, and they went for a world speed record for, get this, grease-powered cars. Of course, they got the record because there's no world record for grease-powered cars. The diesel truck powered by a V6 twin turbo motor stormed to a record 95 miles per hour. Wow, what will they think of next?
Aloha, this is Keith Price, Public Relations Manager at Volkswagen of America. We appreciate what you're doing for us, the men and women of the U.S. Armed Services. Be careful out there. Come home safe.
Hello, I'm Howard Mosier, Executive Vice President of Operations for BMW North America, and I'd just like to wish all of you who are in uniform overseas, looking out for all of us who are safe and sound back in the United States, a healthy and happy holidays. We appreciate everything that you're doing for us, and we can't wait to see you back here safe and sound, back with us at the Los Angeles Auto Show in the States.
Stay right where you are. We've got more Ohana Road from the LA Auto Show coming up right after this, while I go find a car wash.
The Dodge Nitro. Sporty. Fun. Safe. And you can get one for only $259 a month at Cutter Dodge Chrysler Jeep. And that's why Cutter says, dare to compare. If you test drive a Nitro but buy any other vehicle in its class, we'll give you your choice of a $50 Costco gift certificate or membership. See Cutter Dodge Chrysler Jeep for full details. The GMC Canyon. Tough. Safe. Durable. And you can get one for only $299 a month at Cutter Pontiac Buick GMC.
And that's why Cutter says, dare to compare. If you test drive a Canyon but buy any other truck in its class, we'll give you your choice of a $50 Costco gift certificate or membership. See Cutter Pontiac Buick GMC for full details.
The aftermarket segment of the automotive industry has never been hotter, and here at the LA Auto Show, there's an entire hall devoted to customization. If you're into chrome, you're in the right place. Check out this beautiful 1948 Lincoln, sparkling brighter than the day it was built. Likewise, a gorgeous 1956 Chevy Bel Air convertible with just a bit of bling bling. Or how about this brand new custom Chrysler 300C convertible in my favorite color? Maybe wheels are your thing. From sports cars to SUVs, it was Pimp Daddy all the way. And if you think graphics give a car more personality, you might like this Mini Cooper with its own travel trailer. Maybe you'd like to get some bigger tires for your car because all those potholes. This might work. Chrysler is a big presence here at the show. Some exciting new products, starting with the launch of the new Sebring. Company execs showed off the latest version of the popular Chrysler Sebring, its new flagship sedan. Chrysler also chose the LA Auto Show to debut the much-anticipated 2008 Chrysler Sebring retractable hardtop with top up or down at the touch of a button. The Sebring convertible is sure to be popular with Hawaii's visitors.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the all-new 2008 Chrysler Sebring convertible. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of the hit CBS TV show, The Ghost Whisperer, Mrs. Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Joe.
Hi, Jennifer.
Hi.
Great to have you here with us, Jennifer.
Oh, it's great to be here. You know, not many people know this, but I'm absolutely crazy about cars, and I've been trying to get to visit the LA Auto Show for about 6 years. And I've got to say, I love your products. It looks great.
Well, thanks for the compliment. I'm glad that you finally could make it here. So, what do you think about this one, this beauty, our latest all-new Sebring convertible?
I think it's absolutely beautiful, and I could really see myself in this, so.
Is that a hint?
Uh-huh, hint. No, it has great style, great features, and economical as well as perfect for LA, so. Thank you guys so much for having me, and I'm glad I got to be here.
Well, thanks for joining us at this event. Really appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, bye-bye. Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Bye.
The new Sebring convertible truly rises above the rest.
Chrysler's Jeep division was showing off its latest models, like the Go Anywhere Jeep Wrangler, the closest link to the original Army Jeep. And now, for the first time in history, a four-door Jeep Wrangler. And one of the newest Jeeps, the Commander, the first Jeep with three rows of seating. Now, with a salute to the troops, here's Jason Vines.
On behalf of everyone at Daimler Chrysler, thank you for what you do every day for this country.
Over at Mitsubishi, it was all about the company's brand new SUV, the Outlander. Mitsubishi's advertising manager, Mike Nash, explained part of the Mitsubishi philosophy of building cars.
You know, we have a little saying around the company, kind of the mantra is, you know, we'd rather be fanatically loved by the few than sort of liked by the many. You know, our engineers kind of build cars they'd like to drive. I think now the true Mitsubishi DNA is coming out, and that's kind of reflected in cars like the Eclipse and the new Eclipse Spider and this new Outlander behind us, which is an interesting vehicle. I mean, it's really, really competitive in a very competitive segment, but it's got things like magnesium paddle shifters and a 30-gigabyte hard drive Navi system, complete with downloadable music feature where you can download 1,000 songs if you want, and it's really quite an interesting vehicle. Myvec V6 engine, and you know, sometimes you can get a lot of those features, but they're very rarely found in cars that range from $20,000 to $30,000. I mean, those magnesium paddle shifters are usually in, you know, Ferraris and exotic race cars because they're really inspired by rally racing. So.
And finally, Mike offered some words to our troops.
You have no idea how thankful the rest of us are that you guys are serving and doing what you're doing that enables the rest of us to have the freedom and the pure delight of being with family and friends safe back here at home. So on behalf of Mitsubishi and on behalf of, I think, all of us, I don't think I know all of us, thanks a lot.
We hope you enjoyed this special edition of Ohana Road and a salute to the troops from the auto industry here at the 2007 Greater Los Angeles Auto Show. We'll be back in Honolulu next week. Be sure to tune in. Remember, Ohana Road does air twice a week, Saturday nights at 6, Sunday nights at 11, here on Island Television KITV4. For more show info, be sure to check out the Ohana Road page every Friday in the Honolulu Advertiser's TGIF section, and you can visit us on the web at ohanaroad.net. That's .net. On the next Ohana Road, Anita Hall and I will focus the spotlight on what we call four-cylinder V8s. Then on Car Mania, we'll go indoors for a popular form of motorsports called stadium off-road truck racing. On Concepts and Classics, it's an up-close look at a couple of 2008 future cars from Chrysler, the Dodge Challenger and the Chrysler Imperial. And on Hawaii Stars and Cars, it's our Kolohe friend Pipi checking out the All Ford Show. All that plus a bunch of Maloney. So until next time, I'm Dale Payson. Mahalo, everybody.
Now catch Ohana Road two nights a week, Saturday at 6 and Sunday at 11. Catering by Brew Moon, contemporary island cuisine and quality microbrews. Anita Hall's wardrobe provided by Cache. Special thanks to GO, Hawaii's low-fare airline and the official airline of Ohana Road. Cars provided by Cutter Family Auto Centers.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.